In August of 2020, the Ontario government in Canada announced that a prison was to be built in Kemptville. Kemptville is a small rural town of about 4,000 residents in the county of North Grenville. The municipal council has chosen not to fight the plan, and many residents feel betrayed and abandoned by their elected mayor and councillors. We asked some of the residents to share their thoughts on the government's plan. How do you feel about the plan to build a prison in the heart of Kemptville?
I don't like the idea. But the reason I don't like the idea is because of all of the misinformation that's surrounding the whole project. There's lots of arguments about use of agricultural land, humanitarian type things, better prison systems. I think everyone agrees with that. Whether you're for or against, everyone buys into those ideas. But as a taxpayer, I'm really, really concerned what it's going to cost me. Well, the simple reality I know from being on the police service board is there's 7,503 properties in North Grenville, and they're the ones who pay the taxes. And 300 of those are commercial properties. So no matter how you look at it, 7,503 taxpayers, properties that are actually paying for things, is a small tax base. And that's the real number.
I just moved to Kemptville almost 4 years ago. And for me, it's my place to retire, enjoy a safe and friendly community. The prison coming to Kemptville is not what I had in mind. I'm very active. I love to do sports. I use the rail trail. So Kemptville is a very, very small town with 4,000 in population. So really, I don't think a prison is a good idea in a small community.
I really dislike the idea. When we're supposed to be working on reconciliation, does it really make sense, especially on unceded land?
The previous Liberal government launched a review and some legislation concerning redevelopment of detention centres in Ontario. This was just before Premier Ford took over. And at that time, the plan was to replace the Ottawa-Carlton Detention Centre with a 750-bed facility. The discussion involved closing the Ottawa-Carlton Detention Centre, and no plan was made as to where the replacement would be. Then along comes Premier Ford and Steve Clark. The cost of this new facility compared to refurbishing and expanding the Ottawa-Carlton Detention Centre really should be raised. As well, there's more going on behind the curtain with our current government than we see. Gutting of environmental assessments in a COVID relief bill, etc. So I kind of wonder if the Highway 43 funding that's necessary for current development going on is not being used as somewhat of a lever to keep our council quiet on this particular issue, as Mayor Peckford said, battles that she can win.
I remember when the prison was first announced.
Yeah.
And I remember your reaction.
Yeah, I was so pissed. I thought, why are they putting a prison here? Yeah. Why would they do that to such a great little town?
Trying to get information about what this really looks like before we make major life decisions like leaving. Yeah.
Do you have confidence in the government's claims that the prison will bring significant economic benefits and job opportunities to Kemptville and North Grenville?
In the long run, it may actually cost me as a ratepayer. There's so many questions that are unanswered. People start off with misinformation. There's going to be 500 high-paying jobs in Kemptville. Nonsense. That turns out to be a fallacy. Then we get sort of this clever notion, well, there'll be 500 wallets coming to town every morning. Very cute, maybe catchy, but at the same time, even the person that made that statement admits that it's a gut feeling and he has no facts to base it on.
I think that some of the people that are already working in other facilities like Ottawa will be probably transferred to Kemptville.
Councillor Barclay's claim that 500 workers will be coming into Kemptville on a daily basis to work at the prison may be correct, but I suspect if they are going anywhere other than the prison, they will probably go to Walmart, and they'll also be polluting the air around here.
Economic impact. Well, that's lovely. No new jobs here. Construction's not going to be a local firm. Corrections officers, they're not going to hire 500 new folks. This facility is going to be state-of-the-art, hence a very desirable place to work. Corrections officers work by seniority. You can bet that the senior staff from OCDC in Ottawa, Brockville, etc. will be applying for positions here. Ottawa and Brockville are acceptable commutes. Local businesses, staff from the facility won't be going out for lunches locally. They'll eat in the cafeteria there or bring a bag lunch. Their breaks are not long enough to go downtown. Policing costs for the OPP. those are going to go up. A case in point is Napanee, who is currently in negotiations with the Solicitor General to try to handle the increased costs. The province isn't going to pick up that increase for North Grenville. Also, the province pays a grant in lieu of property tax. As the mill rates rise here with each new budget, will the province up the grant, or will the shortfall be out of the pockets as well as policing costs? Local merchants aren't going to see a benefit. Out-of-town staff at the facility will shop at home where they normally do, not at B&H. Given the current and probable future housing market, will there not be an influx of correctional officers buying houses here? I don't think so. Local folks, matter of fact, applying for correction officer positions are probably not aware of what it takes. Application, then extensive screening, and the applicant has to pay $1,000 for that. If they get through it, then it's 6 weeks of training in Hamilton, which the applicant also pays for, with no refund on graduation. If successful, the new applicants are going to get posted to wherever there's backfill needed because of the influx of seasoned correction officers that are going to come to a facility in Kemptville. So what's the benefit to North Grenville from the institution here? None that I can see, just costs added to the residential base.
Can you share any concerns you have regarding Kemptville's capacity to host a 235-bed prison?
We get a letter from the ministry that says they are going to pay for all of the infrastructure. I'm an old bureaucrat, and I understand who signs what and why. That letter was signed by the deputy minister, not by the minister. The reason it was signed by the deputy minister, in my opinion, is it gives room for retrieval if the minister chooses to change their position. We always looked at where is the best level to sign so an adjustment can be made. A prime example, and I'm quite familiar with it, is the cost of policing. That's a big unknown. There's discussions. We may or may not know what the results are, but the simple fact is the cost of policing is going to be paid by those 7,503 taxpayers. If there's an increase for calls for service, we pay for it. That's what I also find so frustrating. I look on Facebook and there's a lot of people who would say, we are not in our backyard. I look at where they live. They don't live in my backyard. They live somewhere else. To me, those are the real not in my backyard people, because what they're saying is, you got it, we don't want it. And we're quite happy if it stays there. There's been no cost benefit. It's all just people yapping in the wind until they actually do as a study to determine it. I think it's a bit of a joke when you have members of council saying, well, we talked to other mayors who have prisons and they say it has no impact on their community. What mayor is going to say, the prison's made our community a dump? The prison has brought us more crime. The prison has increased our costs. Mayors are cheerleaders. Of course, they're going to say, there's nothing wrong here. Come, bring your money here. I think that's a bit of a fallacy.
With 4,000 people as our population, we don't have the transportation to accommodate a prison. Right now, even our hospital, if you go to the emergency, the wait time is 4 hours. We don't have an adequate system here to accommodate such a large facility like a prison.
Infrastructure. Supposedly, the province will pay for upgrades to infrastructure. What gets built has to be maintained. That's cost going to fall to North Grenville residents. One infrastructure that wasn't spoken to is support services for prisoners. Those on day passes, released to halfway houses, we don't have any of that. Support groups such as the Elizabeth Fry Society or counseling, we don't have it.
We have no public transport in this area. We don't even have private transportation, taxi services, or even Uber. So how the visitors are going to get around, if visitors are going to be allowed and it's not all going to be via Zoom, I don't know. And who is going to pay for the upgrade in improving the infrastructure? Who is going to pay for that? Is it going to be the provincial government, or is it going to be the local taxpayers?
The lack of social services at the end of the day, like for the people who are already in the community and in such a small community where we don't even have public transportation, like we're so small.
We don't even have a community center or a Y or anything.
And then the question is the taxpayers, can we afford it? And a big city can absorb a prison.
They don't really ever put prisons in such small towns, do they?
But to put something like that in this town when nobody's asking for it and people are just asking for more information and worried about what the consequences are going to be and not getting it, it's straight up weird. How are the families going to get here? I mean, we're assuming everybody has a car to get to Kemptville. Like, there is no taxi anymore, actually. You know, we briefly had one. That was nice. Uber won't even come and get you out of here. It's strange. We have such little information in reality.
Yeah.
Where is our economic impact study? Not providing you with information doesn't make me feel warm and cozy. Once it's up and running, what's the cost? The OPP bills? That's surprising that the Ontario Provincial Police go to an Ontario Provincial prison or correctional complex to deal with what's going on there, and then they charge the municipality.
Yeah.
Like, that's just straight up weird.
8 months after a Kemptville resident submitted an access to information request, the Ontario government released only 10 out of 145 pages. Would you like to comment on what the government did disclose?
There are so many reasons why they shouldn't have brought the prison to this community. So many reasons why it did not qualify. When I read it, all I come to one simple conclusion: political decision. All it is they've decided this is a safe riding for Clark. And when I've looked at it, everyone in North Grenville, which will not be the case, but everyone in the North Grenville could vote for anything other than him, and he'd still get elected just because of the nature of his constituency. So, yeah, I read it, and I thought, yeah, all it does is confirm this was nothing more than a political decision, a safe place to put this. Of course, there'll be lots of buzz. There'll be lots of naysayers. There are people who says no, and who cares? At the end of the day, we'll win the seat. End of story.
What shocked me the most was the fact that Kemptville had 3 ticks against it, and a lot of the other places that had been suggested had 3 ticks as well, and they were rejected. So what makes Kemptville special?
Information about the assessment criteria for the new location has been largely withheld by the government. One item in particular, public transit as a necessity, stood out in those pages. So what's being hidden? What was released had a mention of future expansion, a mention, and no answers given when directed to that point. That makes me wonder. When I put it all together, it rather smells.
Any additional thoughts you'd like to share?
Be honest. Treat us with respect. I am offended to some extent that council has basically determined, and it was stated, that my concerns are BS, not worth considering, should be dismissed. That's insulting. So that I took offense to. Our issues are not BS. We need someone to actually carry our concerns forward. I don't believe that's happening at this stage. The decision's been made. It's a political decision. This is a safe riding. Big deal from their perspective. It's certainly a big deal from my perspective. And then I was quite surprised the other day. We had members of our local council basically say, if you don't like it, don't vote for me. That's all based in what I sense at this stage of the game is this overconfidence. Maybe a degree of arrogance, not something that I would expect from a first-term council, maybe a third-term council, but no, they have to treat us with respect. We have valid concerns, we have legitimate questions that need to be answered, and they should be answered. It's just because you jumped on the bandwagon at the very beginning, before all the facts were there, it's totally honorable to step back, have a second look, and maybe say, I didn't quite get that right. That would be nice and refreshing as well.
I'm sure that we could do something else with the land that would be more beneficial to the residents of Kemptville, especially if you look at this land agriculture and also just winning the participation, 100,000, that we are all very, very active here in Kemptville, and we could use the land for something more active. We are lacking in a lot of recreational facilities, so that could be another idea. I think for me is the government chose Kemptville because they know they have the land to expand. And I think that's what the people don't know, is that they will start with 200 and some beds in the facility, but they will eventually expand. That's not what we want in Kemptville. We're not equipped for that, and I think the money can be used somewhere else.
Let's hope they don't have the hunger strikes like they have had at many other Ontario prisons, because they're treated unfairly, because these places are built for one person per room. But then they throw 3 in, and then they're already talking about this correctional complex being set up for expansion.
Mm-hmm.
Prisons in Ontario. All of them are 6 wings. You know, is that what we're really getting?
The families are not going to be able to come in to visit their family that's in prison, because are they busting those people in? No, they're not going to do that. And now what are they proposing? That they just put them on a screen, right?
Oh yeah, the screen. We've talked about that enough, having teenagers, what the screen does, and how, especially through the pandemic, it's been realized that screen time does not do anything for your prefrontal cortex. So you're not having that same emotional response to that interaction. And people who have been put in prison need that to get better.
One other thing, too, is logistics. If I'm right that many staff are going to come from out of town, how do they get to the facility? From Ottawa, 416 Van Buren, Highway 44. From the south, 416 and 44. Over 500 staff running shifts, so traffic volumes are going to be an issue. I've not heard of any plans to put a new exit on 416 to service this facility, so the traffic load will affect local commuters who work in Ottawa or Brockville. And those are my thoughts on why I don't want this here. My taxes are high enough.
I've just lived through, as we all have, 18 months of Zoom video calls. Personally, I hate them. Meeting with family that way, I find it very impersonal. You're not in the same room. You don't have the feeling that you're with your loved ones. It's like they're on the TV. I just don't think that Zooming your visitors is the way to go.
I want the prisoners at the old prison to have better accommodation, but I don't think there should be a prison at all.
If you could say something directly to Minister Steve Clark or Premier Doug Ford, what would that be?
Please listen to the locals in this area. We do not want the prison. Most of the people who live here do not want the prison or the correctional facility. A lot of the people are under the impression that this decision has been made and is irreversible. That is not true. It is absolutely not true. And if more of us let the powers that be, like Premier Ford and Minister Clark, not to mention the Municipal Council, let them know that we do not want a prison in this area. As an alternative to a prison, the money might be better spent making the court system a lot speedier. Also, there are other forms of facilities that could be placed in Kemptville. Rehabilitation for drug and alcohol abuse, for instance, would be much more preferable than a correctional facility.
I would like to see more circle justice in our law system, rather than just tossing them somewhere that may not actually do anything to help them or heal them. No little village should have to be overdeveloped and made into a prison town.
Steve Clark and Doug Ford, I would say to you, please, please listen. Listen to the people that live in Kemptville. And a lot of people are shy and not able to talk at the moment because they think it's a done deal. I don't feel it's a done deal. I think that the money could be spent in a better place. I worked in mental health for many years, and there is a need for money in mental health and to rehabilitate these people. They don't need to go in a jail to be rehabilitated. Obviously, if they committed a crime or something, it's because they have some issues, deep issues that have to be dealt with. So please think about it and spend your money in a good place. Thank you.